Hello students, today we are going to discuss about equilibrium of floating bodies. Equilibrium of floating bodies. According to law of flotation, weight of floating body, will be equal to the weight of displaced liquid by immersed part of the body. A body will be in equilibrium only if the resultant of all the forces on the body is zero. किसी भी बॉडी पर जो जितने भी फोर्स एक्ट कर रहे हैं, यदि सारे फोर्सेस का रिजल्टेंट जीरो हो, इट मीन्स देर इज नो एनी रिजल्टेंट फोर्स ऑन द बॉडी. इफ रिजल्टेंट इज जीरो, देन वी कैन से बॉडी इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन. इफ वेट ऑफ द बॉडी एंड बॉयंट फोर्स एक्ट अलोंग डिफरेंट लाइन्स, they will form a couple by which body will rotate. Let center of gravity, it means weight of the body W, is downward and buoyant force is in upward direction, but both line of action of weight and buoyant force are different, so they form a couple by which the body will rotate. जैसे हम बोलें कि जो दोनों forces हैं W and B, W is in direction, downward direction, B is in upward direction, but line of action are different, then the resultant force will not zero in this case. Here W is equal to B, even then W is equal to B, but they are not in same straight line. That's why they are form a couple by which body will rotate. For a equilibrium, W and B should be along a same vertical straight line. It means weight of the body and buoyant force should be along a same vertical straight line as follows. Like this is a body, W is downward and buoyant force is in upward direction. Both are here, W is equal to P and line of action is same. That's why resultant force is zero. So that resultant force is zero and body is equilibrium. This is not a free body, it is dipped in liquid partially. We can frame the complete diagram. ऐसा बोल सकते हैं, बच्चों को डाउट हो सकता है फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम बनाने से. नाउ देर आर फॉलोइंग कंडीशंस फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम. कंडीशंस फॉर इक्विलिब्रियम, फर्स्ट कंडीशन इज weight of the body is equal to weight of the displaced liquid by immersed part of the body. Second condition is a body can be in equilibrium if the center of gravity of the body and center of buoyancy must be along a same straight line. The center of gravity and center of buoyancy are in same straight line, then the body is said to be in equilibrium condition. In this case, the resultant force will be zero. ऊपर वाली जो कंडीशन अपन ने डायग्राम से आपको बताई थी वो यही शो कर रहे थे कि यहाँ पर इक्विलिब्रियम कंडीशन है. एंड थर्ड पॉइंट इज फॉर स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम. इसको हम टाइप्स ऑफ इक्विलिब्रियम में ले लेते हैं. फर्स्ट इज स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम. इन दिस इक्विलिब्रियम center of gravity of body lies vertically below the center of buoyancy. This is a floating body. Center of gravity is here. That is called W. And center of buoyancy is here. This is B. This is W. These are the centers. Center of buoyancy and this is the center of gravity. Both are in same line and center of gravity is downward. It is lower than the center of buoyancy. So for stable equilibrium center of gravity of body lies vertically below the center of buoyancy. In second case, this is case B, unstable equilibrium. In unstable equilibrium, buoyant force is downward, it is lower side, and it means this is center of gravity and this is center of buoyancy. So we can write in case of unstable equilibrium center of buoyancy lies vertically below the center of gravity. Center of buoyancy is downward and center of gravity is in upward direction. The direction this is buoyant force. Buoyant force always acts in upward direction and weight of the body always acts downward, but position of the buoyancy, center of buoyancy and center of gravity is opposite. Here B is center of buoyancy is down. It is lie below the center of gravity. This is center of gravity and this is center of buoyancy. So center of buoyancy जब नीचे होता है ऐसे हमेशा buoyancy का जो direction होगा जो act करेगा वो तो ऊपर की तरफ ही करेगा. Gravity हमेशा नीचे की तरफ ही काम करेगी, पर दोनों के जो centers हैं वो सेंटर जैसे वेट का जो सेंटर है ग्रेविटी का जो सेंटर ऑफ ग्रेविटी है ये डाउनवर्ड हो और बॉयंसी का सेंटर अपवर्ड हो तो दैट इज स्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम. बट यदि ये रिवर्स हो जाते हैं जैसे कि यहाँ पर हम देख रहे हैं बी का जो सेंटर है वो अपवर्ड है डब्ल्यू का सेंटर डाउनवर्ड है तो दैट इज दिस इज अनस्टेबल इक्विलिब्रियम. दैट्स ऑल.